will hopefully provide some protection to some of these people. And so, I mean, you're driving through, you know, doing stories, and here all of a sudden is an entire community circled by sandbags. And I mean, it just, I'm trying to explain to my parents in Pennsylvania, like, I'm trying to take cell phone videos when I'm going down just to be like, I have never seen something like this. And so as far as what I've
seen. Josh Duhamel is on the phone. Can you hold
yes,
on one
I,
second?
Yes, I can hold
I'm
for Josh.
484.
You want to let her talk to him?
Okay, let me get this picked up here. Hi, this is Sean.
Sean.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing, buddy?
Not too bad. Who am I speaking with?
This is Josh Duhamel.
Josh, where are you calling from?
Moscow.
No kidding.
I've been glued to my computer watching you guys on Ustream. You know, it's difficult to see some of the stuff that's happening there right now.
Yeah, it really certainly has made a very big impact, I think, not only to North Dakota, but is certainly garnering a lot of attention around the world. So I have to ask, Josh, how did you first find out about what's going on all the way halfway around the world here?
Well, my sister and my whole family is Minot, and I've been keeping in touch with them and trying to, you know, see how bad things are going to get, and they're moving out of their house, and looks like they're going to lose their place too. And I'm sorry to hear that you and Jim and Perry and everybody are going to lose their houses. It's heartbreaking.
Yeah, and we certainly appreciate that. And that was actually my question. Does your family have a place to go here in Minot? What's kind of their? I mean, you don't have to go into great detail, but do they have a place to go?
Yeah, my sister is going to be staying at my mom's place. They live on the south side of town. They're up a ways, so they shouldn't be affected by it, thank God.
Oh, yeah.
But, I mean, it's horrible to see. I mean, you see places that I knew growing up, Sammy's Pizza, Ramstead Junior High, all these different places that, you know, that it's just... Like they were saying yesterday on the news, you see these things happen in other places around the country and around the world, but when it happens to you, it's a little bit more impactful, I guess.
Yeah, when it hits home and you start to realize the places that we grew up in areas like that are now essentially in the face of destruction, it certainly does take on a whole new meaning. When you grew up here, Josh, I think for some of the people, because we are literally broadcasting around the world as you're watching in Moscow and in some of the other places, how long did you live in Minot? And, you know, just kind of give me the idea of what Minot meant to you growing up here.
Well, I mean, it's still home to me. This is. I went to elementary, junior high, high school, and college in Minot, and lived there till I was 22 years old. So, I know. I'm seeing these places that are in the flood zone. It's just unbelievable. You hear about, you know, there's threats of floods here and there, but and just even a couple weeks ago, my sister was out in L.A. Visiting with her husband and the kids, and there was a threat then that something was going to happen, then it didn't look like it was going to be as bad, and so everything seemed fine, and all of a sudden, boom, this happens. And I feel a little bit silly sitting here in Moscow promoting a movie when I feel like I want to be home.
Well, and, you know, if there's any one thing that I can tell you, Josh, Tom and I were just even talking about that, you know, we have to create, we have to keep some sort of normalcy in our lives. I mean, even, you know, my wife and my kids were displaced among the 11,000 plus people in the area, but I think it's that one thing that we need to try and create a little bit of normalcy in our lives to basically get through this. And I know that sooner or later, yeah, it's all going to come to terms, and I'm sure you and your family are going to rally around and help your sister. And I believe your sister kind of lives down in that area that Jim and Perry live in. You know, it's just the... Down by the fairgrounds, yep.
Yeah.
In that Souris area, Souris Drive area. But, yeah, it's really tough to come to terms with the idea that when you leave your home, what you're going to come back to is just something else.
Yeah, well, you know, if there's anybody that's equipped to handle something like this, it's the people of Minot. And, you know, I've been talking to my sister, and I've been talking to the Red Cross for the last couple of weeks. We were going to try to put something together quickly, a couple of weeks ago when it was happening, then I decided that it's maybe best to push it till the end of the year when we can really organize it the right way. They do something in Santa Monica that I've been working with them with for the last couple of years called a Red Tie Affair, where they raise a whole bunch of money and they have a big event where, you know, with the auction, you know, people pay a certain amount to have a table and all these things. And we were thinking about doing that, but now it seems like there needs to be something more, more quickly put together. And so I don't know what to do. If you got any ideas, let me know. I'd be more than happy to
Even like we were talking, Josh, looking at the North Dakota State Fair, trying to decide if this thing is even going to happen. You're talking about a number of acts that have been booked long in advance. You know, we've got Toby Keith and some of those other fine folks that we were hoping to see this year. And like we were discussing, you know, we may have to have an event that it may not be the state fair that we know. It may be a state fair that we just pick out a pasture and, you know, throw up a stage and have an event like that. But, you know, and we were even talking, you know, having benefits and things like that down the road as the floodwaters recede because, you know, like we were talking about, I don't know if you were listening earlier, but this very well could be September for a lot of us that even get back into our homes. You know, if the haste, you know, might be, I don't want to say premature. I know the city of Minot would be more than grateful for anything that is put together for any help, and whether that's just helping with the folks that are displaced or, you know, just a community effort to help get the city back on its feet. That's something that can be considered down the road. And
I thought you were going to ask me if I wanted to come in and sing a few songs or something. Nobody wants to hear that.
You know, that's about like me.
Miss his wife.
Well, yeah, Kate sitting next to me, and she said maybe he can convince his wife. I think she might be able to carry a tune.
Well, she sends her best, too. Believe me, she knows all about what's going on. She's in France right now. I'm going to see her
in France. Okay.
In a couple of days, and, you know, she loves coming back to Minot with me, and she loves my sister and the family and everybody, so she's feeling for you guys, too. So who knows? I'm going to try to talk her into doing something.
Okay.
Because I think people would rather see her sing than me.
Okay.
I can't promise anything, though.
We're not going to hold you to anything whatsoever here. Because
we are going to do some kind of an event, though, at some point. But I like that idea of doing, you know, even if we can't do it at the fairgrounds, do it somewhere else.
Josh, you know? Were talking about going to Ramstead Middle School?
Yeah.
Earlier, we've got a picture on the screen. I don't know if you're webcasting right now, but it's a picture from the 69 flood of Ramstead, and they actually still to this day, Josh, have that watermark on that main door. When you walk in, you can walk straight ahead, and it's about a 5-foot line on the wall. And unfortunately, if we don't get a levee system built around that school as well, we are going to have to add a new watermark that is going to be about 7 feet higher.
Oh my God.
Than what it was in that picture. So, I mean, that kind of gives you an idea and gives everyone else watching the tragic fate of what's headed for all of the Souris Valley. So, you know, it's tough to swallow for any of us. And like Kate said, she's brand new to Minot and is coming into, you know, a community that's pulled together to help save as much as we can and knowing what's ahead for all of us. But, no, I'm certainly, you know, it'd be great to talk down the road, like you said, to put something together, whether what that timeline might be. Who knows? I mean, we're in such uncharted waters right now with a situation like this. One of the Facebook, we've been answering a lot of Facebook questions throughout this event, and even Kayla Peterson said, you know, events like WeFest, but fundraisers and things like that. It's so early to even try to nail something down, but, you know.
Well, that's the thing. You know, it's all happening in real time, and I'm just sort of, you know, it's hard to really grasp how bad it's going to be. So, so I'm not sure. I wish that there's something I could do immediately. I mean, one good thing is that I'll be able to bring some attention to it and raise as much money as I can and bring, you know, let people know that, you know, there's going to be a lot of displaced people in Minot for quite a while. And, you know, whatever help that they can give would be, you know, tremendous. And so that's what I'm going to try to do for now. And, you know, down the road, you know, whether it's a month or 2 months, we're going to try to put something together to raise as much money as we can to help those people that are in need right now.
And I can only say, speaking on behalf of everyone, we would be tremendously grateful, if nothing else, for than more than for the attention. That's certainly one of the first hurdles to get over when we talk about trying to recover from something like this. And I think, Josh, if you keep an eye on our webcasts and pictures on Facebook like that, we'll hopefully try to keep you in the loop and everyone else on exactly what kind of mess we're going to be dealing with. Because right now we're just basically in the throes of the beginning from a Black Hawk helicopter ride that I even took today, looking at just...
Yeah, I saw the footage of that.
Yeah, it's unnerving to watch all the water that's coming down and knowing it's coming to your house. So,
well, you guys are doing a tremendous job sort of keeping everybody apprised on what's going on. I can only imagine what you guys are going through. My heart's with you.
I appreciate
and,
that.
And I'm thinking about you. And, you know, we're gonna get through it. And we're going to try to, you know, help in any way that we can. So, hey, I don't know, maybe you and I can do some kind of a duet.
I think the duet between the two of us would probably do more harm than good.
We might raise about $4.
Pay Sean not to sing.
Yeah, they might pay us not to sing. That might be the best bet.
We might lose money on that one.
Hey, buddy, thank you so much, Josh, for calling in. And Minot is more than happy to have you, you know, as one of our own. And we thank you so much for thinking of us in this time of need. And all the best to your family, your sister, and your mom, and to everybody else. And we certainly hope to hear and see from you in the future. And for the time being, you know, take care in Moscow, and we hope to see you soon.
All right, my man. Be good. And my thoughts are with you guys.
Appreciate it, Josh. Take care.
Okay. Bye-bye.
So, that was pretty cool.
Josh Duhamel.
That was pretty cool.
Is that your first conversation with him?
That's actually the first time I've ever talked with Josh Duhamel.
You know what? And I'm going to say this, and because you know, I've watched the Transformer movies, but you know what? On my DVR, to this day, I still record Las Vegas, and I've seen him 3 times. It's on TNT.
Very nice.
You know, so.
Josh, if you're still watching, I appreciate you so much for thinking of us in this time of need. And you know, even there's a lot of people in Minot that. Are just truly happy to know that you're still one of our own here in Minot. And thank you so much for thinking of us. And yeah, absolutely. Down the road, we might be able to talk about something to help put Minot on the map as far as trying to, you know, help the less fortunate out in this situation. One of the people posted, if anyone is looking to help out Minot right now, help out those who are at some of the shelters and things like that, the Red Cross is looking for donations, whether it's monetary or even things like toiletries and things like that. There are going to be a lot of people displaced for a very long time. It could be months of living in, let's be honest, shelters. So if you are looking at helping anyone out in the immediate now, donations can be sent to the Red Cross. You can go on and look for the Mid-Dakota chapter of the Red Cross. Can we put up that telephone number for the Red Cross? I know it might take a second to jump onto that CG machine and unlock it, but there it is. It's 852-2828. If you're looking to donate, the Red Cross is doing an amazing job right now in helping with the displacement of the people here in the Magic City, and not only in Minot, but in Burlington, but in Sawyer. We have so many people that are going to be out of their homes. It certainly would be a great idea to reach out now, and then we'll worry about the bigger picture as we go along as well.
You know, how about thinking, like, say you're living in Logan, and 2 days ago you hear one number, which is bad enough, and then all of a sudden you wake up the next day and it's 3 feet higher for the projected crest.
Yeah.
I mean, this is not just Minot.
It's Ward County along the